Wouldn't you prefer a report that looks like this, but you keep getting stuck with a report that looks like this? The data's the same, it works functionally, but the design is a completely different story. And today I'm going to walk you through simple code-free steps to completely transform your Power BI reports using images. Hi, my name is Anne from Adair-Major Consulting, and today I want to show you how simple, smart design decisions can absolutely change your reports. They make your reports look professional, they make them easier to use, and I guarantee you will lead your users to using them more. Part one is simple branding. This is a small instant change that we can make that uses an image to suddenly make your report looking like default to your brand. So here I've started by removing the old text box with a company name. You could keep it, of course, but the text alone doesn't really say branded. It says placeholder. To replace it, I go to insert an image, and I found the logo file on my computer and dropped it in, positioning it neatly at the top. What's important to know here is that this image is now embedded directly into the Power BI file itself. But that's also exactly why we don't want to use this method for every image. Embedding hundreds of images into your file would make it balloon in size, which is why I'm going to show you the other method for the next time we use images, which is much more dynamic and lets you use as many images as you want. Numbers are fine, but being able to see a little bit of context or color, like country flags or a product icon, for example, the report suddenly feels more human. So here's what I did. I brought in a small data set of country flags that I found online. These are public URLs that I can use. I'm going to link to it below so you can also use it. It's just a simple table, country codes, and a URL to an image of their corresponding flag. So in Power BI, I just used the standard get data flow, attaching it to my Excel file. In the model view, once the data was imported, I then just created a relationship with this new flag table to my existing sales table, making sure that they were connected on the matching corresponding country codes. And that's our foundation. Power BI now understands those two tables fit together. I also need to make sure that that column in my new table, where the URLs are, it's marked as image URLs. You'll see how important this is as we go along. Before I add any flags in the table, I need to tidy it up a little bit as well so that it's the right size. There's a new feature called Grow to Fit, and it's a great idea, but it's not quite right yet. And I've found that the last column is kind of falling off the edge and I keep getting this horizontal bar. So instead of Grow to Fit for this table, I'm just going to go back to the original setting. That's going to let me manually choose the size of my columns. Now for the fun part, I drag the flag URL field into the table and instantly it works. This is because we've already told Power BI that those URLs are image URLs. Okay, so part two is really about refining the look. And I'm going to share a couple of pro formatting touches that I use in my client reports all the time to really give them a clean edge. So for example, when I added those images, the size is awful. Well, I can change the size to make sure it really fits in and feels balanced. For me, it's about 45 pixels is working well in this table. I also changed the size of my font. About 14 points is usually good, and I put my column headers in bold. This can seem like a small thing, but 14 points is a good standard for accessibility. And now it's about resizing some of my columns and putting them in the right order. A handy tip I use for resizing columns is I hold down shift and click on my column header. While still holding down shift, I can use my left and my right arrow key on my keyboard to resize it. I find this much easier than trying to use it with my mouse. Next, when I'm doing a table, I always make sure I check my column names. Your data field might be called something completely logical for you, but in the context of this table, it's nice to tidy it up. So for example, total sales instead of sum of total sale. All I do for this is I right click each field and choose rename for this visual. That way it only changes here. The data model itself stays untouched. Here's a little bit of a sneaky one that I do. So for the flag column, I'm just renaming it to a single full stop, and you'll see why coming up. For all my numeric columns, I also like to make sure that I'm aligning in the center. So to do that, instead of aligning all values to the center, I went to the specific column formatting section and then changed my alignment just for my numeric columns. And remember that full stop? Well, while we're here in the columns, I go and choose the column with the full stop and change the header font to white, and it just disappears. Now, because I've got the flag beside the country, it looks a lot more cohesive. Then I went to style presets. You might have a theme or a JSON file that's already giving a style to your Power BI report, but if you're not, if you're just using the default like this report, I like minimal. It keeps it really clean and simple. You can also add vertical grid lines or increase row padding. This gives it a little bit of breathing space or makes the table easier to read. Finally, under grid and color, I change it from Power BI's default blue to our brand's yellow. And already, this table is looking and feeling like something you'd see in a finished dashboard. There's not been any code or any fancy modeling, just a few minutes of really clear formatting. And remember, though we've used it here for flags, these are techniques that you can use in any of your reports. Those flags could be as easy as being brand or product images or team photos. Next, we'll take the same logic and make it truly dynamic. We're going to use our own images, which we're going to host ourselves on OneDrive for Business. Part 3 is about bringing it all together. So we're absolutely on our way to a well-branded report. But what we want to do is make sure that every piece of the report feels like it belongs. So next, I want to make everything feel really consistent. Same style, same tone. And then add a little bit of interaction with a proper image slicer. So first, I'll set the grid lines to yellow to match the main table. And then I changed the style preset to minimal. And of course, I didn't think that through because Power BI then helpfully reverted the grid color back to its default blue, but it's quick to change again. After that, I matched the formatting from the table. So font size 14 or 15, and I checked my column headers. The other thing I really like to do with the matrix is change it from being condensed to being a tabular view. This gives the data a little bit more room to breathe, and I think makes it easier to read. I'm then adding in a subtle visual border around the visuals. And at this point, the whole page is really starting to feel quite coherent. But I want to take a step further and really add some interactivity, using images as filters. In the previous example where we used dynamic images, they were publicly hosted, but that's not always going to be the case. So I want to show you how, if you've got SharePoint or OneDrive, that you can host your own images. In this case, I want to use the company's own icons. So I've already saved these to a folder within OneDrive for Business. There's three tiny image files, a cat, a dog, and a rabbit. Then, to create the direct URL, I click Share and choose the Anyone link. I've copied that link into Notepad and I've replaced everything after the question mark with a download equals one. And that's the secret little handshake. It tells Power BI to fetch the image directly. Once I had my URL, I made a quick table in Excel. This was going to be my lookup table. It's just got two columns. Because there's only three rows, instead of connecting to Excel, I actually went to Home, Enter Data, and pasted it straight into Power BI. For tiny lookup tables that don't change like this, this is a quick and easy way of getting that data into Power BI. And just as we did as well with the flags, I made sure that there was a relationship between my categories in my new small table and my original sales table. It's one to many, exactly as I want. This is a quick tip for testing it, is going to a blank page and quickly make a table with, in this case, my category and my image URL to make sure that the two are pulling through as I would expect. Now, this is what you see happens when you don't mark your URL as being an image URL. So we go back to our data view and mark that as an image URL. Then into my test page, and you'll see it all works exactly as it should. I've also pulled in my category from my sales table to check it's a perfect match. That means that I know everything's correctly set up. And I can now use this small lookup table to filter my main sales table because of that one-to-many relationship. Now, let's use those images in building a slicer, which is the fun bit. What I'm using here is just a button slicer, and I'm going to drag in category field from my new lookup table into the slicer. Then under format and images, I can change the source from data and add the field with my image URL. Right away, those icons appeared. You can play around with some of the settings so you can adjust how they fit, fill, fit, or center. I went with fit to keep them tidy because that suited this size. I then turned off the callout values. That removes the text labels, so it's purely the icon that's showing. Now, when I click one of them, I can see it works, but I don't like that black background. It really doesn't work with my white image. So let's go and change the format for that. So I opened up buttons and states. For the different states, you can make different choices. Here, because of that black background, I've gone for selected and changed it from black to white, which looks much more simple, clean, and consistent. I then also added a visual title, filter by category. For slicers, I quite like using the title as the call to action to the user so that they know that these are slicers, and made it bold so it's nice and clear. But I still want some way of indicating which one is selected. There's a couple of different ways to do this, but what I think will look nice is if I use the accent bar. The accent bar is right at the bottom of the format options, and you can choose if you want at the top, bottom, left, right. In this case, I'm going to go with the brand yellow so that when one is selected, the yellow line is highlighting which category has been clicked. And that's it, a beautiful, simple image slicer. No text clutter, just intuitive interaction. But visually, there's still one thing that's really letting it down.
It's important that a report looks good and professional, but it's more important that it's functional. But the best case is where you use formatting and images and design to do both.
So let's fix that now in part 4. This last step is all about the polish, turning a good report into a great one. So what can we do with that chart? I selected the main chart and first just looked at it. The bars are blue, the title is tiny, and the obvious thing to me is to change the colors. What I want to do is use conditional formatting so that my highest values are yellow and my lowest is gray. This means my end user's eyes are going to know where to look. That's telling a story with the data without needing to spell it out. I've then played around with the data labels and adding a subtle border to each bar. But the size and shape of this, I think, isn't really working for the data. And I think actually, especially considering just three categories, cat, dog, and rabbit, that for this kind of data, a pie chart would make much more sense. I know not everybody loves a pie chart, but when there's only a small number of categories like this, it's really great for being able to see proportion and relationships between those small number of categories. All I need to do is have the bar chart selected and click on pie chart. Even my conditional formatting flows through. Now, just final tiny little tidy ups. So for example, especially when you've got visual borders turned on, just always check your padding that you don't have a title pushed right up against your border. Give your report a little bit of breathing space. It's looking really great, but there's one last thing I want to do. I changed the canvas background to light gray. This means that there's an added contrast between the visuals and the background. But the top section with the logo and the slicer doesn't look great. So I've inserted a rectangle shape and set the fill to white and the border off. And all I have to do then is in the format ribbon, make sure I send it to the back. It just becomes a subtle header panel that then ties the top visuals together. This is not the only way to achieve this type of look. And if you had lots of elements, I wouldn't suggest putting in the shapes. But when it's just one like this, it's really quick and easy. And I think you'll agree, it just looks really composed. And there we go. All we have to do now is publish. Looking back on the before and after, it's the same data, it's the same structure, but an entirely different experience. The final version feels branded, clean, and genuinely enjoyable to use. And all of this was code-free. Now, why not check out another code-free tutorial? I'm going to link a video here that shows you how to use drill through. This is a commonly overlooked feature in Power BI, but is incredibly powerful.